Before I tell you anything, I'd like you to try this first. Stand up, you don't need a bike for this, and just do this right now. Stand in a straddled way, just like you would stand on the bike. Stand like this. Now I want you to lower both heels. Can you feel yourself tipping backwards? That's your body's center of gravity moving backward. Everything that happens on the ground obviously also happens on the bike. But the difference is that the ground doesn't react to your body's center of gravity or center of mass shifting, but your bike does. Because on the bike, you are the heavy mass and the bike is the light mass, and you have pedals and the crank arms which introduce your body weight into the bottom bracket and thus influence whether you have traction on your bike or not. Watch this. I am now compressing my bike in its center. Can you see when I compress my bike here how my shock and fork compress evenly? Now I am introducing the heavy mass, my body weight, into the bike over the bottom bracket, and I'm distributing my weight on the wheels, which leads to traction. Here, I now have a scale to show you what happens with the load distribution in the bike when I lower both heels. I'm now standing with my full weight evenly distributed on my legs, no weight in my hands. You can see I have about 28 kilograms of weight on my front wheel. Just a reminder, I have no active weight on the handlebars, but still I have 28 kilograms of weight on the front wheel. This, by the way, is the reason why you do not need to lean onto your handlebar to have traction on your front wheel, but you'll find how to keep traction later in this video. Okay, now I'm lowering both heels. Let's see what happens. Already, I have many less kilograms on my front wheel. I have reduced my traction by several kilograms just by lowering both heels. This is one of the reasons why lowering both heels is not a good idea as a default technique. In short, you are the heavy mass on the bike. If you lower both heels, your calm moves to the rear, the light mass of the bike reacts, you take weight from your front wheel and reduce the traction on your front wheel. Now, I am not saying you never need to lower both heels. You do need to lower both heels to brace against forces which want to push you forward, for example, during heavy braking. Yes, that's when you do need to lower both heels to avoid being pushed forward and getting too much load on the handlebars, as this can catapult you over the handlebars in the worst case. But I am saying that you should not have your heels lowered as a default, because then you are shifting your body weight rearwards, which is too far back for most situations, and it decreases traction on your front wheel. Here's an example of what I mean. I'm riding this steep section with a compression now at the bottom. I'm lowering both heels, and you can see that I'm being pushed rearwards. The bike is accelerating forwards, and in worst case, it can either slip away or fold away. And that is the why based on physics. So now let's come to the why based on anatomy, which is point two. The most natural ankle position is like this. So when you're standing upright, your foot is at about a 90 degree angle to your shin. If you now go into the stride position, just like you would stand on the pedals, and maintain this 90 degrees, you will see that your front heel is automatically lowered and your back heel is not. So now if you force yourself to lower your rear heel, your rear Achilles tendon actually goes into a strong tension, which can be very dangerous in case of impacts. Now, biomechanical why and what you should do instead. In case biomechanics sounds too fancy, related to mountain biking, biomechanics means, in very simplified terms, the interaction between the body and the bike to maintain control, stability, and balance. In an anatomical why, you have already seen that if you allow the natural ankle position, the front heel is low and the rear heel is probably not. In the physical why, you learned why you should not force your heels down, as this will bring your calm, your center of mass, rearwards, and this will decrease traction on your front wheel. in the biomechanical why, you will now learn what you want to do instead. This natural position I'm going to show you now, or which I have already showed you, is front heel low, rear heel slightly upwards. That's the goal for most riding situations. Why? This ankle position is the foot wedge, because you're wedged between the pedals. The foot wedge is a term from the BICP curriculum, and the wedge allows you to be wedged between the pedals, which means say goodbye to losing your pedals if you're on flats, and say goodbye to hanging off your bike and going over the handlebars if you're on clipless pedals. The foot wedge puts you in the ideal position to use your muscles to react to everything. So if your body is being pushed forward, you have the front lowered heel to stop you being pushed forward, to brace against the forces. With the rear heel slightly raised, you have a stop to the rear, which helps you to avoid being thrown rearwards. Of course, you could also pull yourself forward on the handlebars when you are thrown rearwards, but as your front end is light already, pulling yourself forward on the handlebars will further reduce traction, and therefore you are risking a front wheel washout. So now you will see a short clip with a focus on the feet, and can you spot the foot wedge? Generally, the goal of mountain biking is to keep your center of mass over the bottom bracket, to allow your bike to move and the body to remain as still as possible. And the foot wedge is your tool to achieve this. I call the foot wedge and the balanced stance through the feet the essence of mountain biking. The essence of mountain biking. Because the solid and balanced stance through the legs, through the feet, with heavy feet and light hands, will enable you to stay stable, to introduce your body weight into the bike over the bottom bracket, which then helps you to maintain traction, because tiny shifts of the calm through the usage of the ankles and the feet enable you to keep stability, control, and balance. By the way, I call this pressure control, this miniature movements. I will link a detailed video below this video, because pressure control is a bigger topic, and you'll find out there why it's pretty dangerous to lean on your handlebar to have traction on your front wheel.